If you had told me last year that the first season of Ace of Diamond Act 2 would focus very little on tournaments and more on off-field developments, I would have told you that this would be the best season yet. While good baseball scenes generally do get me interested in a baseball show, and while Ace of Diamond has some god-tier baseball scenes, the things that keep me invested in shows above all are plot and dialogue. Basically, if you can get me into the baseball players when they're not playing baseball, you have me hooked. Ace of Diamond doesn't do that for me, but it's clear that it isn't trying to either. It understands its audience cares less about relationships and more about archetypes. Less about character growth and more about character design. Less about plot and more about hype. I don't think there's anything wrong with these priorities, and since this is obviously a successful formula, I don't expect it to change much. But an entire season of Ace of Diamond without much baseball drama sounds like a great opportunity for exploring topics beyond baseball, something the show didn't really do in its first two seasons. But after another year with the show, it's pretty clear Ace of Diamond doesn't have much interest in evolving. In that sense, this season doubled down on disappointment, alienating fans of the show interested in hype by shying away from tournaments, and equally alienating the smaller portion of fans like me who want complexity but get fed the same simple storylines. When we start this season, we're reminded of the mountaintop our boys finally reach in the previous season. Sato's win in the Fall Kanto tournament gives them an automatic invitation into Senbatsu Koshien, putting this show into the hallowed ground for the first time. The animation team doesn't disappoint with this opportunity, and though it's only the spring invitational, and though it's pretty foggy and cold, I'd argue that Koshien has never looked better in anime form. The boys also seem rejuvenated by their appearance, winning a few games before falling in the quarterfinals to a powerful foe from Hokkaido. Furia finally reaches his potential, Sawamura struggles on the mound, all giving us more conflict for our main hero. When the boys return back home, they're met with a new challenge, welcoming the first years. The introduction of Okumura and Yui serves as the beginning to an inevitable transition, when Sawamura and Furia retire and two other characters have to pick up the reins of lead characters. At this point, it looks like Okumura will take Sawamura's place of the quote-unquote main, which flips our attention from a bright-eyed and bushy-tailed lead to a stoic and hardened hero. That our focus also flips from pitcher to catcher seems intentional as well. Major did something similar with its sequel, subverting our expectations by flipping our perspective of the main character from the pitcher's mound to behind the plate. On paper, it's a good move to keep fans interested in the story, one that kept Major fresh and might do the same with Ace of Diamond. But a problem Ace of Diamond has always had is that it doesn't really matter who the lead character is. From the start, the main character could have been Furia, or Miyuki, or even someone like Kawakami, and the feel of the show wouldn't have changed at all. And this is because from the start, Ace of Diamond seems less focused on the arc of its own characters, and more focused on making them fit into certain archetypes that experience little growth or change. This show wants you to pick a favorite character and stick with them knowing that they're going to be the same episode to episode. Mine happens to be Haruichi, and you can only imagine my disappointment when he cuts his hair and falls into a lesser role this season. A lot of people have chosen Sawamura as their favorite character because they will follow the lead no matter what. And while there's nothing wrong with that, there's also nothing that interesting about Sawamura that makes him worth following over any other character. When we meet Sawamura in the first episode, he is brash, loud, and arrogant. And after a couple of years and over 175 episodes of quote-unquote development, Sawamura remains brash, loud, and arrogant. Except more people like him because he's developed some movement on his fastball. Otherwise, he kinda sucks as a character. In that sense, I welcome Okumura as the heir to the lead role, if only because I much better tolerate his personality type than Sawamura's. But even if we got past the point of Sawamura and Furia's retirement into Okumura's rise as the hero, little tells me that this show would change much. Is he going to grab the unquestioned leadership role like Miyuki did in Season 2? Is our wolf boy going to shed his tough exterior and open up to be a more compassionate and gregarious leader? Maybe, but unless the show aims to develop his personality in ways it didn't do with Sawamura, I'm not optimistic this will be the case. What we get through most of this season advertises itself as development, but performs more like filler. And if these practice games and training montages came with a bit more insight into these players' personalities, I would be on board with the entire season. But just like the show did for its first couple of seasons, Ace of Diamond trades quality for quantity, throwing even more new characters in our face in the hopes that one of them will stick after your favorite one retires. Never mind that it could have spent its time selecting one character and developing them into a worthwhile study, maybe even the left-handed pitcher it claims to be the main character. I've long accepted the fact that Ace of Diamond isn't going to address the issues that I want it to address, like the disproportionate power of baseball factories in Japanese education, or the cultural concerns of overwork and hazing in youth sports, or the systematic oppression of women from the country's most beloved game. Even after 3 seasons and over 175 episodes, I still think this show has incredible potential, and would quickly shoot up my list of favorite shows if it tackled even one of these difficult topics. But much like Sato's run in the spring tournament to start its most recent season, all of that momentum it generated from the jaw-dropping animation in its first 2 seasons has amounted to very little. The end of the season gets the summer tournament started, and unlike the previous 2 seasons, we don't get the satisfaction of a clean ending because, well, the story's kind of caught up to the manga. Personally, I don't mind seeing the season end like this, nor do I mind waiting a bit for it to restart, if it does. I can't really predict if a 4th season will come anytime soon, if at all, and if it does, I'll be happy to turn my brain off and watch the pretty baseball show. I don't want to give the impression that I don't like this show. Ace of Diamond is ultimately a fun little cartoon about pretty baseball boys doing cool baseball things. But if a 4th season does arrive, I'm going to need a quick reminder of where I left off before I start. Because between the time I'm done recording this and when the next episodes come out, I'm not going to spend a second of my free time thinking about this show.